Noonim Kitchen for the past 2 years has been collecting reports of violence from refugees and migrants who return back from the border, from Croatia to Serbia or Bosnia. We collect these reports of people who have testimonies of abuse or violence received at the hands of state authorities, and collect these reports in a standardized methodological format, and along with several other organizations present in the region, have a common network that we use to publish these reports. Over the past 2 years, we've collected over 700 unique cases of violence, of pushbacks across the border. Each case represents upwards of 8 people. And so when you think about it this way, these 700 cases can involve maybe 4,000 or 5,000 individuals. The reason that these reports are so effective, or in my opinion, they're so important, is because as No Name Kitchen volunteers, as people who are present along the borders on a day-to-day basis, we have a level of access, of social access to these guys that very few other people or organizations do. That the New York Times or Der Spiegel can come here for 3 days or 4 days and do really great reporting and have a really loud platform to speak to people about this. And Amnesty International or Human Rights Watch can do the same and come here for 3 weeks. But we as No Name Kitchen are here month after month, year after year, and talk to these guys on an everyday basis, so we can see things over time. We can identify extreme cases when they come up and link these cases to these bigger actors. But I think that for that reason it's really important that we're here, because you know, sometimes people die on this route. Sometimes people get lost in the rivers that they cross. Sometimes they get beat terribly, and you don't know, maybe if we are not here, nobody hears about these stories. So it's really difficult to say, to make any definite number on the amount of people who are crossing the border in Serbia or Bosnia, or the number of people who are arriving to Italy, but you can see, for instance, in Balkanici in Bosnia, maybe just this one city, 30 people come back each day who are pushed back. It depends on a given week, but if you can say that 30 people are coming back from the border every day, that these numbers are quite high, that people are crossing every day. And as for the amount that are arriving to Italy, where most go to, that's also difficult to say, but you know, people arrive to Italy every day as well. The Croatian Ministry of the Interior published some information towards the end of the year, towards the end of 2019, and it was informal information on the amount of people that they had processed, of refugees and migrants that they had processed in the country, and it was upwards of 7,000 or 8,000 individuals, I believe, who had been, you know, pushed back by the officers. But again, this is just official numbers. It's really hard to say what the actual number is. Misunderstanding between the local people, the people who are on the route, and the volunteers here. I think that there's a language barrier in many cases, but bigger than that, there's a cultural barrier. When this route first started and people started going on it, there was a tremendous amount of local solidarity from people in Serbia and people in Bosnia as well. But then as time goes on, it becomes more difficult because fatigue sets in or burnout sets in, and you have one or two incidents that are very bad, committed by refugees or migrants, that then the local people see everybody like this. And unfortunately, those perceptions stick and they get worse over time. So at the moment, I think you could say that in a town like Shid, there's very little that local people want to do with refugees and migrants in the community. The problem in general, more so, is the people who actively want to harm or make things more difficult for the refugees and migrants. This is a very small percentage of the total people here, but there are those people within the community who believe this, and over the past several months, with these eviction operations in the squad, it's been quite ugly in some ways.